Howdy folks, so I just wanted to make a quick video about something that I saw recently. I'm sure you're all familiar with the YouTuber Possible History, a Dutch alternate historian who's seen abnormal levels of growth as of late. But what I wanted to talk about was something that I saw not too long ago in a video that he made with several of his YouTuber friends, which he called the Possible History Quiz Show. Let's take a look. In the video, Possible History shows his YouTuber friends a series of maps in which they have to guess the alternate history that led to them. And as I'm skimming through the video, I notice this show up. Of course, this is one of my maps, which appeared in a video on my friend Mr. Z's channel a long time ago, which was on if the Anschluss had never happened. So you may be thinking, well, so what? He used your map, what's the big deal? But after his friends try to take a crack at it, and Possible History eventually gives context for the map, he says this.
This map comes from the esteemed alternate history channel Muncher Z, and it's from a scenario where Austria doesn't get Anschluss. This obviously results in southern Germany breaking away, all of Catholic Europe uniting in an alliance against Protestant Europe, and yeah. This is a real video that exists.
Yeah. So let me give you a synopsis of what actually happened in that scenario. In that timeline, Engelbert Dollfuss isn't shot by the Nazis, and so when Hitler begins pushing for an Anschluss with Austria, Dollfuss refuses and Germany invades. Then, Italy, which was very protective over Austria and had promised to do so in our timeline if Germany had invaded, comes to Austria's support as war breaks out between Italy and Germany, which ultimately gets bogged down in the Alps. Britain and France then, seeing an opportunity, eventually decide to join on Austria's side, crushing Germany on all fronts. And since Dollfuss's refusal for an Anschluss was based in Austrian Catholicism, and since the Allies would want to weaken Germany, Austria annexes much of Catholic South Germany with this alliance and plan, again, being something that was proposed in real life between Italy, Britain, and France if Austria ever came under threat. And as a result, Hitler is ousted from power as National Socialism is crushed, which allows for Catholic authoritarianism to rise in its place, bolstered by a more powerful Austria, which strengthens relations with the nearby states of Hungary and Czechoslovakia. France also sees a rise in this authoritarianism, backed by Mussolini, as France, Spain, and Portugal, as well as Poland, seeking protection from the Soviets, join this new bloc. Then, Hungary and Italy seek to claim land in the Balkans as Britain and North Germany grow closer together in opposition. Now, you can watch the video for yourself, and you can have your own opinions about the scenario. I certainly do, but that's besides the point of how Possible History completely butchered the context of that map for the sole purpose of having a reason to mock Mr. Z and me by proxy. Oh, and also, Possible History never even names me, you know, the person who made the video and the map, instead just pinning it on Z. This would already be bad enough if it weren't for the person who was doing it. If you take a look at Possible History's channel, you'll notice that very few of the videos there are actual serious alternate history scenarios that he's actually created. Instead, you'll find a ton of videos written not by him, but by his viewers, or when he does do something himself, it's some of the most ridiculous things I've ever seen. For instance, what if I created history? What if Germany just keeps trying? Or my personal favorite of this nonsense, what if the Soviets got zombies in World War II? Other videos, like one on if the Christmas truce ended World War I, immediately open with a disclaimer saying the video isn't serious, implying that his other videos are? And then there are those like, what if everything went perfect for the Central Powers? And what if everything went terrible for the United States, whose entire premises are based on mountains of assumptions and completely overlook why these outcomes didn't happen, detaching it from any real understanding of these events. As you all know, I'm not opposed to doing silly scenarios every now and then. But emphasis on that last part. Every now and then. When I do silly scenarios, I only ever do them just as a refresher from my serious stuff. But not this guy. Possible History rarely ever makes any actual serious alternate histories, instead just making nonsense or having other people write for him. And you know what? That might have been fine had he not gone and made a hypocrite of himself by deciding to attack my video, my map, and my scenario as being ridiculous. I was wondering if he'd even been familiar with the basis of that scenario, which was the real-life, short-lived Stresa Front Agreement of 1935. It's not something particularly obscure in alternate history circles, or even in general World War II discussions. And this is when I considered if Possible History was really much of a historian at all. History is a bit of a serious subject, it should be entertaining, but there should also be some educational value to it. I have received plenty of criticism on some of my older videos that they were too heavy on background history, and though I have cut down on excessive background, there's a reason why I give this much, which is because it's necessary to understand actual history before being able to grasp alternate history. Why on earth would someone shovel out history content that's so light on actual history? Why paint your videos and your channel the colors of history of an educational field, but then provide very little in the way of actual educational content when you make your videos? Short answer, views. Mr. Z made a great video on how mass-produced, low-quality content gets widely shared across YouTube, and judging by how much Possible History brags about his view count and subscriber count, as well as this interaction I found, in which a viewer of his suggested a video, and Possible History outright admits he gets enough views to not care about what videos he makes, he clearly cares more about gaining YouTube clout and profit than the actual subject of history and providing videos that are not just entertaining, but educational. Hence, the abnormal growth I mentioned at the beginning of this video. Of course, he knows all of this, and this is all secondary to the real reason he and his friends like to go after people like me, which is difference in political ideology. Possible History's bias is readily shown in many of the first people he's followed on Twitter, including Vosh, and his staunch opposition to channels like Mr. Z and What If Altist, enough that he has made multiple video responses to them, two of which he's since unlisted on his channel. In his Discord server, Possible History has also repeatedly claimed that the success my channel has seen is purely because of help from Mr. Z, a YouTuber who's been a good friend and who was kind enough to showcase some of my work when I was just starting out, with us still doing collaborations every now and then. I am genuinely offended by the accusation that this is the only reason I have seen any success. And once again, it's also extremely hypocritical, coming from a guy who, among his very first followers on Twitter, back when he was almost completely unknown on YouTube, were Alternate History Hub and Emperor Tiger Star, the same two channels that now make numerous appearances on Possible History's channel, such as in the quiz show thing that we talked about earlier. Who's the one being propped up by larger channels again? But This isn't the first time Alternate History Hub has propped up an alternate history channel who shares his worldview and attacks his opposition. Remember our old friend Freda, the Marx appreciator? Well, before Possible History came out with his attacks on Z and What a Faultist, here's Cody promoting Freda right after his own attack videos came out. I guess all it costs to get a shout-out from Cody is to take a snipe at guys he doesn't like. Well, maybe that and having a bit of a bias he happens to like. Whether it's him propping up Possible History or Freda, or his strange relationship with Vosh, Alternate History Hub definitely isn't the unbiased moderate some of his fans think he is. I've already gone over how playing political games with history is dangerous in the video I made on Freda, but what Possible History does is just as bad, filling your feed with junk history for the sake of fame and profit. It's like Mr. Z said in his video on this. Some channels are like McDonald's. What they provide isn't healthy, but it's cheap, easy to produce, and it's popular. And you can bet Possible History is enjoying himself filling his pockets, not caring if what he feeds you is garbage. But hey, I hope you guys enjoyed hearing my thoughts on this, and if you want to see more of my content, make sure to stick around for more. And hey, you could also, maybe, subscribe or something. So that's it for today's video. Well, till next time, see ya.